This tutorial shows you how to conduct the one sample t-test in R and interpret its results. The one sample t-test is used when you want to test for a difference between your sample mean and a hypothesized mean, i.e. population mean. For instance, I have a sample with 51 observations and want to test the mean of the IQ against the average value of 100. Required are a dependent variable on an interval or ratio scale and an approximate normal distribution of this variable. The latter can be done using an analytical test or rather looking at a QQ plot or histogram. As a first step, after importing data, I want to see the mean of the IQ variable for my sample. The mean function provides that answer and the average IQ is 109.8. I now want to see whether that is significantly different from the population mean of 100. For this, I use the t.test function and start off with the test variable, the IQ. After that, I use mu equals 100. To test my sample mean against the population mean of 100. Note that the default testing will be two-sided, meaning you test only for a difference. In case you proposed in advance that your sample mean is larger than the population mean, you can add the argument alternative equals greater, meaning your sample mean is larger than the population mean. If you, however, hypothesized a smaller sample mean, you use alternative equals less. I can now run this one line and get the results. If the p-value is below the predefined threshold, for example 0.05, the null hypothesis can be rejected. Reminder, the null hypothesis of the one sample t-test assumes no difference between sample mean and population mean. In my case, I defined alpha as 0.05 and can therefore reject the null hypothesis, because my p-value for a two-sided test is 3.027 times 10 to the negative 6, so it's extremely small. My sample mean is therefore different from the population mean. If I did a one-sided test for a larger sample mean than the population mean, I could certainly see that result as well. The p-value would be half of that what I see in the two-sided test. After a significant one-sample t-test, the effect size should be calculated, which is shown in the following video.